Honorable Shehu Garba, your point of order.
State. Mr. Speaker, I want to seek the kind indulgence of the House to equally come under Order 8, 46, to draw attention of the House to an incident that happened in my constituency on Sunday night, where a paramount ruler was murdered in cold blood in his house without any apparent reason. I believe this incident fits into the kind of scenario that was painted by the last motion that was raised, and I would like to seek your kind indulgence, Mr. Speaker, to have this matter treated as a matter of urgent public importance so that we can also set aside our rules in order to address it right now.
Honorable Chris Azubogo.
Thank you, Right Honorable Speaker, my distinguished colleagues. My name is Honorable Chris Emeka Azubogo, representing Newi North, Newi South, and the Kusiko Federal Constituency. I stand to second the motion, ably moved by my colleague. I so second.
Those against it say nay.
Ayes have it.
Seconder to the second limb of the motion will be Honorable Jega.
Honorable colleagues, my name is Mohammed Umar Jega, representing Aleru Gondu Jega Federal Constituency of Kebbi State. I wish to second the second leg of the motion that we suspend our relevant rule to take up this matter now.
Support of the motion say aye.
Those against it say nay.
Ayes have it. Honorable Shehu Garba, you can now move your motion.
An urgent call on the Nigerian police to diligently investigate the gruesome cold blooded murder of the district head and other persons in Karshi in Sanga local government of Kaduna State. The House notes the gruesome murder of the district head of Karshi, Mr. Balama Adaki, and his nephew in Sanga local government of Kaduna State on the night of Sunday, 1st May 2006, without any apparent motive. Aware that this same community witnessed an attack about 20 months ago, where over 17 persons were murdered in cold blood, with many houses burned down. Each time there was an attack, no perpetrator have been identified nor apprehended. Worried that this community and others within the local government council now live in constant fear, which has affected farming and other economic activities of the people. The House resolved to observe a minute silence in honor of the dead, and to condemn in very strong terms the unprovoked killings and destruction that took place in Karshi and in other places within the country, and call on the Nigerian police and the Department of State Security to get to the root of the incessant killings and attack so as to bring perpetrators to justice and end the current culture of impunity that seems to be the order of the day in Nigeria. Mr. Speaker, I so move.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Honorable members, my name is Goodluck Opia, President of Hajibema Ogutoru West Federal Constituency. Mr. Speaker, I hereby second the motion, ably moved by my honorable colleague. I hereby second.
My honorable colleague, my name is Shehu Garba Sakinoma. I represent Jamaa Sanga Federal Constituency of Kaduna State. Mr. Speaker, the incident referred to in this motion is into a state of anarchy. Mr. Speaker, this is a case of a community that had witnessed attacks in the not too distant future, where the ruler of the community was attacked, dragged out of his house, and shot several times before being hacked with machete. And this is a community that had witnessed a similar attack not too long ago, where over 17 persons were equally murdered in a similar circumstance without any apparent reason. Cases of murder and killing are not just unique to Nigeria.
They happen all over the world. But what seems to be disturbing, Mr. Speaker, is a situation in Nigeria where life doesn't seem to mean anything. People are killed day in, day out, and no day have we ever had, in very few instances have we ever had the security apparatus come out to perhaps show that they have been able to get to the root cause of this incident and maybe fish out the perpetrators. And I think it is this kind of situation that seems to be giving vent to the experiences that we are experiencing in this country. I think the police must wake up, just like in the case of the kidnap that was, that was the subject of the last motion, Mr. Speaker. I'm sure everybody here is aware now that the Abuja-Okene Highway has become a den of kidnappers. Day in, day out, people, innocent passengers and travelers traveling on this road have become subject of kidnap, some of which we read, quite a lot of others we are not reported. And I think this is a sad commentary, Mr. Speaker, on the state of, law-keeping in this country. And I believe that the issue of killing like the ones that have been the subject of this motion and the issue of kidnapping, which the last motion, sought to address, and similar motions that we took about 2 weeks ago, I think demand that the police and other security apparatus in this country should begin to think outside the box. I think the crisis has degenerated to a situation where we need to address it as a national emergency, because the issue of kidnapping now has moved from a situation where people are targeted in their home to a situation where vehicles are stopped on the highway and people who are perhaps judged to be maybe well off are led into the bush. There is a case of twin brothers that were traveling to Lagos who were kidnapped. Until today, I'm not aware that any information has been found about these children. They were taken into the bush. Until today, the parents have never had anything, from the kidnappers. And so many other instances like that. We've heard about the story of the clergymen along Kaduna, Abuja Kaduna Road, that were equally kidnapped in similar circumstances. And the trend is this: the vehicles are stopped on the highway, people are robbed, and a certain number will be marched, will be taken away and marched into the forest. Sometimes trekking over a period of 6 hours before they get to where their den is, and it is from there that they will attempt to establish contact with the parent. And it's become a common trend, especially between Abuja and Okene. And I think we need to bring this to the consciousness of the security agency, that they need to move outside their usual routine to perhaps regard this matter as a national emergency and come up with strategy, perhaps with the support of the executive arm of government, that will address, if it means hiring experts from outside this country. I think the issue of tourism and business development that we're talking about, or diversifying the economy, can never happen if this country continues